نعم.
القسم الثالث من النساء. And then we have a third type of woman in relation to her menses.
القسم الأول لها عادة معلومة تسمى معتادة.
نعم. We said that the first type of woman is a mu'tada, i.e. a woman who knows her habitual bleeding at this time of the month for this many days.
الثانية مميزة تميز دم الحيض من غيره.
نعم. And then the second type of woman is called a mumayyiza, somebody or a woman who can distinguish between her bleeding of her menses and her normal bleeding.
الثالثة متحيرة يعني احتارت فيها في نفسها وحيرتها معها ما نستطيع هل لك عادة معلومة؟ تقول لا هل تميز دم الحيض من غيره؟ تقول لا طيلة الشهر ينزل عليها الدم فماذا نصنع بها؟ نعم.
And then we have a third type of woman and she is called متحيرة. And this is a woman who she just does not know. Neither does she know, neither does anybody know. So she doesn't have like a habitual bleeding, sometimes at the beginning end for so many days, and neither can she distinguish between her different types of bleeding. Sometimes she might bleed throughout the whole month and she doesn't know, she can't distinguish whether this is menses or normal bleeding.
فإذا جاءتنا مرأة تسأل.
So if now this type of woman she comes and she asks us,
تسأل عن الحيض.
She's asking regarding her menses.
هل أنت معتادة على أيام معينة في كل شهر؟ تقول نعم. إذا هي معتادة تبقى هذه الأيام ما زاد عن هذا فهو استحاضة. نعم.
So this now this woman comes and she asks whether she is a haid, whether she's falling into the category of being a haid. We say to her that do you have habitual bleeding? Do you know that your menses are this time of the month for this many days? If she says yes, then we say that in these days you are now a haid.
وإذا قالت أنها ليس لها عادة معلومة نقول تميز قالت نعم أنا أميز فهي مميزة الذي تميزه حيض فهو حيض وإلا فهي تصنع كل شيء نعم.
And if she doesn't have this habitual bleeding but she's somebody who's able to distinguish between the different types of blood then we say that as long as you know that this blood is now حيض is a blood of menses then you are in that state of being a حيض. And if it is any other bleeding, then it is normal bleeding and it is not حيض.
وإذا قالت لنا أنها ليس لها عادة معلومة ولا تميز صالح يعني ما تميز هذا الدم من هذا الدم فهي متحيرة نعم.
And if she says that neither do I have any habitual type of bleeding and neither can I distinguish between the different types of blood, then she is متحيرة. Somebody who totally does not know whether she's in her menses or not.
نقول لها لهذه المتحيرة نقول لابد أن ترجعي إلى النساء من أقربائك إلى أختها وأمها وخالتها كم عندهم أيام الحيض؟ تقول أيام الحيض عندهم ستة أيام مثلا نعم.
We say to her that you have to go back and ask your mother, your sisters and your aunties, i.e. the females from amongst your relatives and your family. And you ask them how, and you should know about them how many days of periodic bleeding in a month do they have? How many days?
ستة أيام. مثلا قالت أن عندهم الحيض ستة أيام. نعم.
So let's say she says that my mother, my sisters, and my aunties every month they have 6 days of bleeding of the monthly period.
فنقول لها لابد أن تبقي ستة أيام من أول كل شهر هجري تترك فيها الحيض والصيام وغيرها تترك فيها الصلاة والصيام على ما سيأتي وبقية الشهر تصلي حتى وضعت الدم وتصوم الأشكال فيها نعم.
We say to her that the first 6 days of the Islamic month then you have to consider yourself as being in a state of a haid being in a state of monthly periodic bleeding and then for those first 6 days of every Islamic month you leave off fasting, you leave off praying, and we're going to cover this. As for the other days, the 7th, 8th, and the other days of the Islamic month, then even if you're bleeding throughout then this isn't the bleeding of the menses, and you carry on praying and fasting and the other matters.
أعلم النساء في هذا الباب أعلم الناس في هذا الباب النساء وهذا من نعم الله علينا أن لا نحي والحمد لله نعم.
The most knowledgeable or the most aware of people regarding this subject area is the women themselves. And from the blessings of Allah upon us as men is that we don't go through this type of periodic bleeding.
الذي يكون محدث حدث أصغر يعني خرج منه ريح أو بول أو غائط أو ريح نعم.
A person
من عليه حدث أصغر.
A person who is in a form of minor impurity, meaning he has urinated or he has answered the call of nature or he has passed wind as an example.
يحرم عليه.
Then it's not permissible for him
أن يصلي
to pray
أو يطوف بالبيت
to make tawaf around the Kaaba
أو يمس المصحف
or to touch a mushaf, touch a physical copy of the Quran.
إذا من عليه حدث أصغر يحرم عليه ثلاثة أشياء. نعم.
So therefore, the person who is in a minor form of impurity, three things are not permitted for him. He's not allowed to do three things.
الصلاة,
prayer,
والطواف, ومس المصحف.
Prayer, making tawaf around the Kaaba and touching the Quran.
أراد أن يصلي أو يطوف ومس المصحف. نقول توضأ واصنع هذه الأشياء الثلاثة.
So this person, he now wants to pray, or he wants to make tawaf, or he wants to touch the Quran, a copy of the Quran. We say to him, go make wudu, and then you can do these things.
ويحرم على من عليه حدث أكبر. كنزول مني مثلا نزل منه المني يحرم عليه نعم.
And as for the person who is in a state of major impurity, the hadith al-akbar, for example, he has a discharge of semen, then he's not allowed to
يحرم عليه هذه الأشياء الثلاثة الصلاة والطواف ومس المصحف نعم.
Then firstly, he's not allowed to do those three things, i.e. he's not allowed to pray, and he's not allowed to make tawaf, and he's not allowed to touch a copy of the Quran.
يحرم عليه قراءة القرآن.
And also, it's not permitted for him to recite the Quran. يعني بدون مس هذا القص.
الأول الذي في الحدث الأصغر هذا لا يمس المصحف لكن يقرأ القرآن بغير وضوء ولا أشكال به. لكن من عليه حدث أكبر لا يمس المصحف ولا يقرأ شيء من القرآن. لا قليل ولا كثير.
So just to clarify, a person who is in a minor state of impurity, then he can recite the Quran from his memorization, but he can't touch the mushaf. As for the person who is in a state of major impurity, then neither can he touch the mushaf, the Quran, and neither can he recite the Quran even off the top of his head.
ولا يلبث في المسجد إلا إذا أراد يبقى في المسجد وهو جنب يتوضأ ويبقى في المسجد. هذا ليس من باب رفع الجناب ولكن من باب التخفيف. يخفف من أثر الجنابة إذا أراد أن يبقى في المسجد. نعم.
And also a person who is in a major state of impurity, then he does not sit or stay in the masjid, unless he needs to sit and stay in the masjid, so he goes and he makes wudu. Now this ablution that he makes, this wudu that he makes, this doesn't mean that now he isn't in the state of major impurity. It doesn't mean he can pray, for example. But it means that it has lessened the level or the seriousness of this impurity.
هذا الأخ يعمل في هذا المسجد.
So for example, this brother, he actually works in this masjid. He works in the masjid.
وهو الآن عليه جنابة عليه اغتسال لأنه نزل منه مني نعم.
And he's in a state of major impurity. He's in a state of janaba because of a sexual discharge.
وراد يدخل المسجد لحضور الدرس مثلا.
And now he wanted to enter into the masjid in order to listen to a lesson, for example.
أو النظافة.
Or because he works and he cleans the masjid.
نقول ما تدخل المسجد حتى تغتسل ثم بعد هذا تدخل.
So we say to him that don't enter into the masjid unless you make a ghusl first and then you enter into the masjid.
أو توضأ وتبقى في المسجد لا إشكال في هذا لكن لا يستطيع أن يصلي أو يقرأ القرآن أو ما ذلك. نعم.
Or we say to him that go make wudu and then you can sit or work or clean in the masjid, but you're still in a state of major impurity, so you can't recite the Quran, you can't pray, and so on and so forth.
مرة أخرى.
So one more time.
الذي عليه حدث أصغر.
The person who is in a state of minor impurity.
لا يصلي ولا يطوف ولا يمس المصحف.
He doesn't pray, he doesn't make tawaf, and he doesn't touch the copy of the Quran.
يقرأ القرآن ولا إشكال.
But he can recite the Quran without touching it.
ويبقى في المصحف المسجد ولا إشكال.
And he can remain in the masjid, and there's nothing wrong with this.
من عليه حدث أكبر اغتسال.
As for the person who is in a major state of impurity in janaba, then he has to make a ghusl.
لا يصلي ولا يطوف ولا يمس المصحف. نعم.
Then neither does he pray, neither does he make tawaf, neither does he touch a copy of the Quran.
ولا يقرأ شيء من القرآن.
And neither does he recite anything of the Quran.
ولا يصح له أن يبقى في المسجد إلا إذا توضأ.
And neither is he allowed to stay or reside in the masjid unless he makes wudu.
الحائض والنفساء.
As for those women who are in a state of periodic monthly bleeding or postnatal bleeding,
احرم عليها الأشياء كلها التي ذكرناها. لا تصلي.
Then all of these things which are mentioned, then also they are not allowed to do it. So she doesn't pray.
ولا تطوف.
She doesn't pray while she is bleeding. Another does she make tawaf.
ولا تمس المصحف.
Another does she touch a copy of the Quran.
ولا تدخل إلى المسجد.
Another does she enter into the masjid.
ولها أن تقرأ القرآن.
Another does she recite the Quran. Another does she recite the Quran.
ولا تصوم.
Another does she fast.
ويحرم وقتها.
And also it's impermissible, it is impermitted for a person, it's impermissible for a person to have intercourse with her.
يعني إذا عندنا ثلاث درجات.
So therefore we have three levels.
حدث أصغر ثلاث أشياء.
A person who is in a state of minor impurity, three things that person can't do.
حدث أكبر خمس أشياء.
And a person who is in the major state of impurity, five things that person cannot do.
الحائض والنفساء يحرم عليها هذه الأشياء كلها إلا قراءة القرآن. نعم.
As for the woman who is in her menses or postnatal bleeding, then all of these things are impermissible for her except reciting the Quran.
ومع أنها لا تصوم.
And also she does not fast.
ولا توطأ.
And neither is a person allowed to have intercourse with her.
ولا تطلق.
And neither is she to be divorced. You're not allowed to divorce her in this state.
والله أعلم صلى الله على نبينا محمد وآله وصحبه وسلم. جزاكم الله خير.
جزاك الله خير. جزاك الله خير.
And just to clarify, the next lesson is in مركز فاطمة.
إن شاء الله الدرس القادم بعد صلاة العصر يا إخوة رجال ونساء في مركز فاطمة الساعة السادسة تماما. 6 o'clock في فاطمة ستر إن شاء الله.
نصلي هنا ولا في المركز؟
نصلي هنا.
مركزين.
يصلي في مرات الصلاة. الصلاة الخامسة بس. جزاكم الله خير بارك الله فيكم صلى الله عز وجل يبارك في ميزات حسناتك وحسنات الشيخ ان شاء الله
الله يبارك في حسناتك
قبل الله منكم شر الاولاد جعل الله واياكم الذين يستمعون الصلاه